it hurts. And I am too sexy for Milan, too sexy for Milan, New York and Japan.
Hello, you have reached the Cellular Communications Devices automated voice message recording for the corporate executive office of Lucifer B. Mephistopheles, the lead executive branch 4, HAL Incorporated, a subsidiary company of the I Say So company. Because here at I Say So, I Say So. Here in HAL we are the leading pioneer in torture tactics, covert intelligence information, spiritual enlightenment and other various soldier of fortune, mercenary type third-party business ventures. As can be expected, our chief management representative cannot be reached at this time as he is most likely sleeping with your wife right now while you're busy being stalled by this message. Please, take your time and leave your soul at the beep, otherwise we won't care enough to call you back. Thank you and remember, hairy butts are attracted to Russian women.
The most commonly accepted etymology derives warlock from the Old English erloga, which meant breaker of oaths or deceiver and was given special application to the devil around 1000 AD in early modern Scots. The word came to be used as the male equivalent of witch, which can be male or female, but has historically been used predominantly for females. The term may have become associated in Scotland with male witches due to the idea that they had made pacts with Old Horny, the devil, and thus had betrayed the Christian faith and broke their baptismal vows or oaths. From this use, the word passed into Romantic literature and ultimately 20th century popular culture. A derivation from the Old Norse Vathloka, caller of spirits, has also been suggested. Considers which the Old English etymology, traitor. This has to be the weakest definition I've found on Wikipedia yet. So let me expand upon the thesaurus here on this term. In traditional covens, when someone is branded a warlock then they are an exile from that coven, cast out from the protection of their brethren and forced to wander the world, alone. This tradition has been in place since the 16th century and it is surprising to see that even the most openly available information that the general public should have access to, have forgotten. I do not know what has happened to the art of magic but I suspect something has run afoul. The heavens seemingly hoard the mystic knowledge condemning those who use it, then turn around and not only use it themselves but claim it to be originally their craft. It slowly becomes more clear that whoever or whatever is leading these beings of light is not benevolent at their source. They subjugate the masses to their will. They do not seem to align with anything I have ever considered as angelic. They are not a place that should be called my eternal resting place. I have realized that while fighting to uphold the image of God's virtues, though I cannot rest peacefully within heaven and amongst those who have shown me a lifetime of scorn and a cold shoulder when I offered help, I cannot help but wonder what I shall do for an afterlife now? Wander as an unbound spirit, I've done that most of my life. Continue being the hero? Nah, the world never loves a hero and all I would get is more scorn and just as soon stay in heaven, I'd get the same results. Going to hell is a one-way disaster awaiting destruction. Eventually I would become used so much that the opposition would see me as the critical tipping point that would bring peace from the chaos, which it wouldn't, they would just find something else to use. Anyways, back on topic, a warlock is usually marked in some way, as following the tradition of Cain, and is cast out similarly so, shunned from other covens and forbidden to be associated with. They are not given sanctuary nor consideration until they have atoned for whatever transgression they have committed. This all is decided before a tribunal council under due processes to be followed. The next subject I want to discuss is the deity of my persona or avatar Angrimaring. Angrimaniu, Avastan, destructive spirit, Middle Persian Ahriman, the evil, destructive spirit and the dualistic doctrine of Zoroastrianism. According to the earliest version of the myth, he is the twin brother of Spentamaniu, the Holy Spirit, and both were the sons of Ahuramazda, or Mazda or Ormazd, the wise lord and supreme deity of Zoroastrianism. Angramani'u, of Astan, destructive spirit, Middle Persian Ahriman, the evil, destructive spirit in the dualistic doctrine of Zoroastrianism. According to the earliest version of the myth, he is the twin brother of Spentamani'u, the Holy Spirit, and both were the sons of Ahuramazda, or Mazda or Ormazd, the wise lord and supreme deity of Zoroastrianism. Angramani'u's essential nature is expressed in his principal epithet, Drudge, the lie, which expresses itself as greed, wrath, and envy. To aid him in attacking the light, Spentamani'u, the good creation of Ahuramazda, Angramani'u created a horde of demons embodying envy and similar qualities. Despite the chaos and suffering affected in the world by his onslaught, believers expect Angramani'u to be defeated in the end of time by Ahuramazda. Confined to their own realm, his demons will devour each other, and his own existence will be quenched. In a later dualism, Ahuramazda, still the creator god, is himself the force of good, Angramani'u is his evil, destructive counterpart, and both exist from eternity. The modern Zoroastrians of India, the Parsis, tend to diminish the importance of Angramani'u by explaining him away as an allegory of humanity's evil tendencies. Ahuramazda is thus restored to omnipotence. That's the definition according to the Britannica. Let me expand this understanding. Angramani'u is the title that is given to the hierarchy of hell and the demonic representations of the principalities of evil itself. Each act that is truly derived of being evil in nature, such as murder, betrayal, seduction, blasphemy, tyranny, desolation, defilement, fury, desecration, conviction, greed and envy. That is not all of them, but the main difference that divides these actions from typical acts of sin is the desire within the hearts of those who commit them. Such as lust, this is a simple carnal core of desire itself that can lead to the wrong choices and bad habits that can lead to a short lifespan among other things. Seduction, however, is the intentional act of using desire to lure someone astray from the path they walk or beliefs in themselves that can then be exploited and turned to weaknesses. The ultimate destination for all sins is destruction. Continue living a life full of sin and you will inevitably become a victim of your own evil deeds. Your life will no longer be in your own control but instead a puppet, manipulated by other evil forces and denied escape from your own misfortune by the evils you committed upon others until you have no options, no paths left to choose and everything you've worked towards and accomplished returns to the dust from where you came. That is the point and purpose of salvation that God offers in His mercy. Salvation from us and everything we are and have done, from becoming lost to the winds of oblivion and returning to the sands from where we came. To return from the path of sin, for salvation for those who did not realize the extent of what their deeds would bring about and seek to change themselves before their situation becomes worse. The path of redemption was made and brought to us by the life of Jesus of Nazareth. Through the wisdom that has been established through his name, the counsel provided in times of duress, the parallel associations of stories and scenarios that outline advice through decisions taken by others that led to the salvation from scenarios similar to the one who may be learning of the ways of redemption. Through these teachings, that wise men with good intentions usually referred to as saints, they brought to the world and incorporated it into the original teacher of the path of redemption's lessons and expanded it into what has become an unclear and misrepresented religion. I think I see my next subject of focus. I have helped re-establish the virtues of the Father, now I sense that his Son is in need of the same. Ultimately, this endeavor I seek will restore the righteous path for others to see and have a choice once again, that will hopefully in the end stop others from suffering being born of sin like I was. I realize that the world we live in is facing extreme limits and hazards threaten the very extinction of mankind, but I choose not to allow that to sway my path and consume my mind with fear. It is obvious that there is an afterlife, and so thus death of the body is not the end of this journey. There are loads of controversial evidence to support that belief. Besides, I enjoy the person I have become along this path, someone I can look back upon with respect. Many may not fully understand why I do the things I do sometimes, but I do, and I can look back and smile upon what I have become, especially when in contrast to what I once was. So for those who seek evidence to the power and possibilities of redemption and salvation, simply look upon my works with the eyes of one who has been there and walked the path of evil, and see what I have become now, inside, and see that redemption for even the most violent sinful is possible, no matter your deeds.
This has been a high-cost operation. Let us hope my predecessor's faith in it was justified.
The self-destruct sequence has been activated. This sequence may not be aborted. All employees proceed to the emergency car at the bottom. The self-destruct sequence has been activated. Repeat. The self-destruct sequence has been activated. This sequence may not be aborted. All employees proceed to the emergency car at the bottom. The self-destruct sequence has been activated. Repeat. The self-destruct sequence has been activated. This sequence may not be aborted. All employees proceed to the emergency car. The self-destruct sequence has been activated. Repeat. The self-destruct sequence has been activated. This sequence may not be aborted. All employees proceed to the emergency car at the bottom.
Stabilizing. All phases complete. Download. Stabilizing.
It's everything we'd hoped. Worth waiting centuries for. The coordinates to the Xenomorph homeworld.
In the midnight hour, she found
And now for a commercial advertisement written and directed by, hold on, we're having to check the prompter. Is that what he really scripted for my lines? Okay, I got it. Let's just keep going and we'll edit all this later. What do you mean the editorial department is out on COVID-19 sick leave? No, God doesn't have his own editorial department to do this. Don't you think if he did, maybe I wouldn't even be here? Geez, this labor force nowadays have gotten real cocky, walking around like their 401k don't stink. Alright, from the top. This commercial advertisement was written by the illustrious supreme leader and multi-talented dictator with a Sonic the Hedgehog mop. Okay, cut. I fucked up my lines. I forgot to remember not to think about his hair when speaking about him, damn it. Okay, here we go, let's just finish. The supreme leader of North Korea, the best Korea, wishes to show his ability to extend mercy and understanding even to those of inferior genetic quality such as his, for Asians may have small penises compared to white Congo jungle orangutans like Americans, but that only applies to Chinese Asians. All Korean males are born and breed with superior penises with a guaranteed stamp of authenticity from the Rock of Gibraltar Erectile Enhancement Company. Now for an episode of The Adventures of Kim Jong-un. who they call the Rocket Man because he likes to rock out with his supreme cock out.
It is late, sir. Do you require a sleeping cake?
Kim Jong-un, my son.
Kim Jong-un.
It is true. I was dead. But then robot stuff happened, and now here I am. I, your father, have returned. Pah! Weak and emotional as always. Disgusting. Now show me my kingdom. It's worse than I expected. You have completed none of my plans. Great Satan America and False Korea remain unconquered. Infant plastic surgery is far from universal. Australia still stands in the way of my memorial centaur. Squirrels continue to secretly mock us. I know they do. Don't deny it. There is only one clear course of action. Kim Jong-un must die.
But sir, consider his accomplishments, his celebrity friends, his discovery of the female super orgasm.
Meaningless. When it comes to Kim Jong's, there can only be one.
A Highlander quote. An inferior Western film that failed to meet Kim Jong-il's cinematic standards. He would never reference it. You can speak. Weird. This cyborg was being controlled remotely. I will hack its mainframe and discover from where. Yes, hacking, hacking, continuing to hack. Aha! I have located the signal. Shall we follow it to its source?
Blah 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 bl